आई सेल्फ शमशाद अहमद, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, TABPG कॉलेज सिवान. टुडे आई हैव टू डिस्कस नॉट हीट थ्योरम्स. एट द बिगनिंग ऑफ द 20th सेंचुरीज वाल्टर नॉट नोबल प्राइज विनर्स इन 1920 had investigated heat capacity and heat of reaction at progressively lower temperature. As a result of his studies, he initiated an important principle that initially was restricted to the behavior of reactions involving solid and liquid, but which is now believed to apply to all processes and substances. The subject of chemical thermodynamics is dealt with more fully in chapter, but for the present we shall note that some chemical reactions requires an input of heat to initiate them. Other chemical reactions generate heat. The former are known as endothermic reactions. The latter are exothermic reactions. If the reaction take place at constant pressures, the heat gain or lost is an increase or decrease in enthalpy H. The heat of reaction is usually given as delta H, enthalpy change, being positive for an endothermic reaction and negative for an exothermic reaction. It should be noted that spontaneous reactions are by no means always exothermic. Some spontaneous reaction result in the absorption of heat from their surrounding and in a corresponding increase of enthalpy. Nernst had noticed that at progressively lower temperature, the change in enthalpy and the change in the Gibbs functions during a chemical reactions become more and more equal, and the rate of change of the Gibbs functions with temperature becomes lesser and less as the temperature is lowered. That this amount to the same thing is evident from the Gibbs-Helmholtz relation. Delta H is equal to delta G minus T differentiation delta G by delta T at constant P. What Nernst proposed was that in the limit as the temperature approaches zero, the change in the enthalpy and Gibbs function are equal, or what amount to the same thing, the temperature rate of change of Gibbs function at constant pressure approaches zero at zero temperature, that is differentiation delta G by delta T at constant P must be equal to minus delta S. This implied that chemical reaction at a temperature of absolute zero take place with no change of entropy. This is Nernst's heat theorem. Planck letters extended this to suppose that not only does delta G tends to delta H, but as T tends to zero, GH, GTP, this has a number of consequences. For example, until now we had defined only what is meant by a change in entropy. In particular, in order to state what entropy of a system is at some temperatures, you would need to know what the entropy is at a temperature of 0 Kelvin. In sections 12.8 and 12.9, we attempted to calculate the change in Helmholtz and Gibbs functions as a system was changed from one state to another. We found that the right hand side of equation 12.9.9 and 12.9.11 for calculating the changes in this function contain the entropy. We later went on to show how you could calculate the difference in entropy in some state to that at zero temperature, but there was still a matter of an arbitrary constant, namely, what is the entropy at zero temperature. We now have the answers resulting from the observed behaviors of G by T, big bracket S, differentiation dp is equal to minus as the temperature approaches zero, namely that the arbitrary constant is no longer arbitrary and the entropy approaches zero as the temperature approaches zero. That's all. Thanks.